Everyone. So welcome back, class 9, subject English. This is our revision lecture, and in this lecture we are going to revise two topics. First is chapter number 3 of Beehive, The Little Girl, and poem 3, Rain on the Roof. Now let's see first The Little Girl, and in this lecture we are going to look for three topics. Chapter number 3, The Little Girl, then poem 3, Rain on the Roof, and then we will discuss the homework solutions of the previous chapter, that was chapter number 3 of Moments, Ishwaran the Storyteller. First, we will look for the summary of chapter number 3 of Beehive, that is The Little Girl. The Little Girl is the story of a little girl, Kezia, who misunderstood her father's strictness and usually remained scared of him. She kept a distance from him whenever he would be at home. So this chapter, this lesson is about a story that depicts the relationship between parents and their children. A little girl, Kezia, who initially remained horrified at her father's appearance, as her father was very strict and she would maintain distance from him. She considered him to be as big as a giant. She would often get nervous and stutter and stammer while talking to him. She longed for his love and affection like her neighbor Mr. McDonald. So she was yearning to receive, to have the affection, to have the love of a father, which she was not getting. Instead, she was getting rudeness, punishment and strictness. And she compared her father with Mr. McDonald, her neighbor. Once she was kept indoors as she was affected by cold. So she did not go to school as she was suffering from cold. Her grandmother suggested that she make a gift for her father's birthday next week. So her grandmother suggested her to make one beautiful present for her father. They decided that Kezia would make a pin cushion for him. Kezia made a beautiful pin cushion, but she accidentally made a mistake. She filled it with bits of paper that she got by tearing her father's important speech. So she wanted something to stuff inside that pin cushion, and she went inside the into her mother's bedroom. She found some papers that were there on the table. She tore them off and she filled the pin cushion with those papers, which were actually his father's important speech. She was punished for that. This incident further estranged Kezia from her father. That means the gap, the distance which both were having elongated with that incident. She would often look at the neighbors, the McDonald's, playing joyously in their lawn. So when she used to look out in the garden, she used to see her neighbors, Mr. McDonald's family, and the children used to play with her father, and the family used to enjoy a lot. While watching such fun and laughter which those children were having, she used to feel jealous. She used to admire the love and affection which they were getting, and the same love and affection she was deprived of. Mr. McDonald was such a good father and played so lovingly with his children. She wondered, he might be a different sort of father. So while seeing Mr. McDonald playing with his children, she used to wonder that it might be there are different kinds of fathers, and only her father was the strict one, whereas all others are not like her mother. Once her mother fell ill and was hospitalized. So what happened? Her mother fell ill and she was hospitalized. So she was left alone at home under the care of the cook Alice. So she was there all alone in the house with the cook Alice and her father only. At night she had a nightmare and woke up screaming, as she was not habitual of sleeping alone. She used to sleep with her grandmother, but eventually that night her grandmother had to accompany her mother, who was hospitalized, so she had to sleep alone. She found her father standing by her bedside, and when she woke up screaming while watching that nightmare, she found her father, who was standing by her side. He picked her up and took her to her room. That was the first time that she was lying so close that she felt the love and affection and care for what she was yearning for so long. He tucked her up in his bed and soon fell asleep. He put her close to him, and as he was so tired, so he fell asleep. Kezia felt secure lying near her father. She felt secure, she felt the love and affection, and she was inside very happy. She realized that her father was not as big as a giant, and that day her intentions, her imaginations, her thoughts, everything got changed about her father. She felt the beating of her father's loving, large heart. Finally, she realized her father was very loving and had a generous heart. Finally, that night she realized that her father is also a human being and not a giant. He is also filled with emotions, but it is due to the hard work that he had to do all day long to earn for the living of his family that he could not play with her and that he could not spend time with her. So she realized that her father was also loving and had a generous heart. So this was all about this chapter, chapter number 3. Now let's see poem number 3, Rain on the Roof, written by Coates Kinney. So, Rain on the Roof. In this poem, the poet tries to describe how he feels on a rainy day. The poet is describing the healing power of rain. He states that whenever it rains, he starts to recall all his past memories. It is a very quite common phenomena that when it rains, we eventually revise the past memories and we all feel happy, all our sadness, sorrows and destructions gets vanished. While lying on his bed in the cottage, he listens to the pitter-patter sound of the raindrops which were falling on his roof. As he listens to the sound of the rain, he starts to remember his old days when he was a little boy. Huge clouds that are full of moisture move around in the sky, and the raindrops that seem like a tear falling from the sky wipe the sad darkness of the night. Moreover, the poet is comparing the raindrops to tears, as to him the dark sky seems very sad. Also, it appears as if it is weeping, and the raindrops are the tears shed by it. So the poet has compared the raindrops with that of the tears of the sky, as the night was dark, which represents the sadness, and it appears to him as if the dark sky seems very sad and it is weeping. The poet expresses his feelings when he hears the raindrops falling on the roof of his house. That means when he was lying in the cottage bed and he heard the sound of the raindrops falling on his roof, he expresses his feelings. That is, he says that every tinkle, every sound, every pitter-patter sound of the raindrop on the shingles, on the tiles of the roof, has an echo in the heart. Whenever he hears raindrops, echo in the heart means with every raindrop falling on the rooftop, its sound repeats in his heart and in his dreams. And that means the sound repeats means the sound revives the old memories, the old good memories of the past. Further, he has many different and fantastic imaginations. So the poet is sharing with us that when he was lying in his cottage bed, there were thousands and thousands of memories that arose in his mind, and he shares one of those memories with us. For instance, he recollects many memories of the past which come back into his mind as dreams. Hence, he listens to the patter of the rain upon the roof. He has many new dreams in his mind, and his memories of the past come back in the form of dreams. The poet introduces his mother and says that he is dreaming of his mother. As in the previous stanza, that rain brings memories of the past, that means initially he shares his feelings that as he was lying, he was lost in the old memories, and the first and the foremost memory that comes in his mind was the memory of his mother. They were the memory of his mother, who is no longer alive. Long ago, his mother used to love him a lot, and she uses to consider him a darling. However, the sound of rain makes him correlate his past with his present. That is the reason he was so moved by the sound of the raindrops on the shingles of his room. Every time he hears this sound, it brings back memories of the past as he reminds of his mother. So the poem is about rain on the roof. That means the poet is sharing, is expressing his feelings that the healing power of the rain, that is when one hears and feels the raindrops, any person can go back in his past and will make him remind the fancies, the dreams and the good thoughts of the past. As the poet was also lying in his bed and he was also lost in the past memory of his beloved mother. So this was about this poem, Rain on the Roof. The homework solutions of chapter number 3, which I gave you in the last lecture, to solve the text. Now the first question is, in what way is Ishwaran an asset to Mahendra? Answer: Ishwaran is an asset to Mahendra as he accompanies him everywhere. He cooks food for him, washes his clothes, cleans the living place and entertains him with his unique stories. Question number 2. How does Ishwaran describe the uprooted tree on the highway? What effect does he want to create in his listeners? Answer: Ishwaran would raise his eyebrows in a curve and raise his arms in a dramatic gesture. He would say that once he was walking down the empty highway all alone. He saw a huge beast lying on the road. He thought of going back, but as he got closer, he saw that it was a tree that had broken and had fallen on. Its branches appeared to be the beast's limbs that had spread out onto the road. He wanted to create a scene in the listener's mind so that he would get captivated in the story. Ishwaran wanted to create curiosity in the mind of the listener as to what happened next in the story. Next question. How does he narrate the story of the Tusker? Does it appear to be plausible? Firstly, he gave an introduction that his village was surrounded by a dense forest. The wood was processed at the timber yards and the logs of timber were transported onto the lorries by elephants. He added that the beasts were huge and in case one of them went mad, it could not be controlled even by an experienced mahout. he would get so caught up in the excitement of his own story that he would get up from the floor and jump about, stamping his feet in emulation of the mad elephant. Ishwaran's talent of narrating a story was praised. That means it was quite worthy. He put in a lot of effort to make it engrossing for the listener, to indulge the listener in his story. Next question, why does the author say that Ishwaran seemed to more than make up for the absence of a TV in Mahendra's living quarters? Ishwaran seemed to more than make up for the absence of a TV in Mahendra's living quarters because his stories were so entertaining that every night they made up for the absence of a TV in Mahendra's living place. He would enjoy the unique way in which Ishwaran narrated a story which was full of adventure, suspense and horror. So there was no need of TV in Mahendra's living quarters, as Ishwaran himself was a full source of entertainment. The next question, Mahendra calls ghosts or spirits a figment of the imagination. What happens to him on a full moon night? Mahendra scolds Ishwaran and says that ghosts do not exist. On a full moon night, he woke up from his sleep as he heard someone crying. At first, he thought that it was a cat which was hunting mice, but as the sound grew louder and harsher, he was forced to peep out of the. In the white moonlight, he saw a dark, shady figure holding a bundle in its arms. Initially, he got scared, but overcame it as he felt that his subconscious mind had played a trick on him. The next day, the presence of the ghost was confirmed by Ishwaran, and Mahendra realized that he actually saw a ghost the previous night. He did not want to live at a haunted place and so resigned from the. Last question, can you think of some other ending of the story? I think the story has ended in a good way. I cannot think of another ending for the story. In this answer, you may write your own thought if you think that the story can end in some other way. So, your homework is that you have to revise chapter number 3, The Little Girl, and poem 3, Rain on the Roof, thoroughly. And after the revision, you will be solving the assignment which is there on your EdQuark site.